The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
As I looked at the readings that were set for today in our Anglican lectionary, at first I could find nothing to say about them. They didn't really inspire me, although the psalm is full of praise. But as I read them again and asked God what he wanted me to take out of them, I began to realize that all three, in fact, spoke directly to me. Psalm 148, verses 1 to 4 and 13 to 15. It's a song of praise to God, and so let me start by reading it. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights above. Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all his heavenly hosts. Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you shining stars. Praise him, you highest heavens, and you waters above the skies. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. His splendor is above the earth and the heavens. He has raised up for his people a horn, the praise of all his saints of Israel, the people close to his heart. Praise the Lord. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Of course, we should praise the Lord, and that's just what we've been doing in reading and in listening to that psalm. It gave me great joy to read it, and I hope it did to you too as you heard it. But when I thought about my own prayers, I realized that I spend far more time thanking God rather than actually praising him. Gratitude is part of praise, but I don't think it's enough. We don't also acknowledge the greatness of God. Perhaps it's because I'm more comfortable with Abba Father rather than with an awe-inspiring, unfathomable, and also quite unimaginable God. It is good to know that we can approach God and that he hears our prayers. But sometimes, perhaps, we need to be reminded that we should approach him with reverence and awe, praising him as we understand something of his majesty and his power. Ezekiel certainly saw something of that majesty and power in his vision. Let me read to you some verses from chapter 1. In the 30th year, in the 4th month, on the 5th day, while I was among the exiles by the Kibar River, the heavens were opened, and I saw visions of God. I looked, and I saw a windstorm coming out of the north, an immense cloud with flashing lightning, and surrounded by brilliant light. The center of the fire looked like glowing metal, and in the fire was what looked like four living creatures. Spread out above the heads of the living creatures was what looked like an expanse, sparkling like ice and awesome. Under the expanse, their wings were stretched out toward the other, and each had two wings covering its body. When the creatures moved, I heard the sound of their wings, like the roar of rushing waters, like the voice of the Almighty, like the tumult of an army. When they stood still, they lowered their wings. Then there came a voice from above the expanse over their heads as they stood with lowered wings. Above the expanse over their heads was what looked like a throne of sapphire, and high above on the throne was a figure like that of a man. I saw that from what appeared to be his waist up, he looked like glowing metal, as if full of fire, and that from there down he looked like fire, and brilliant light surrounded him, like the appearance of a rainbow in the clouds on a rainy day. So was the radiance around him. This was the appearance of the likeness of the glory of the Lord. When I saw it, I fell face down, and I heard the voice of one speaking. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanking God is so important, but perhaps especially in this uncertain time, it's good to be also reminded of his greatness. This is Ezekiel's vision, not actually a likeness of God, but it does give us a sense of his magnificence. He is in control. So, with my mind filled with reverent awe, I approached the gospel reading and found a very different tone that made me come back down to earth, perhaps. But actually, I think in a way, it bridges the gap between heaven and earth. So let's listen to the good news proclaimed in Matthew's Gospel, chapter 17, beginning at the 22nd verse.
Glory to Christ our Saviour.
After Jesus and his disciples arrived in Capernaum, the collectors of the 2 drachma tax came to Peter and asked, "Doesn't your teacher pay the temple tax?" "Yes, he does," he replied. When Peter came into the house, Jesus was the first to speak. "What do you think, Simon?" he asked. "From whom do the kings of the earth collect duty and taxes? From their own sons or from others?" "From others," Peter answered. "Then the sons are exempt," Jesus said to him. "But so that we may not offend them, go to the lake and throw out your line. Take the first fish you catch, open its mouth, and you will find a 4 drachma coin. Take it and give it to them for my tax and yours." This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ our Lord.
This passage reminds us that although we are citizens of heaven, we are also citizens of earth. The thing is that if a king imposes his taxes on his subjects, his own family doesn't have to pay them. After all, the taxes are collected to support the king and his household. So Jesus, as the Son of God, should not have been expected to pay a tax for the temple, his father's house. But Jesus says that he and his disciples should pay the tax so that we may not offend them. What does he mean by that? He's actually saying something like this. We will pay not only to do our duty, but also to show others that they ought to do it too. That's a lesson to us, to claim nothing and to allow ourselves nothing which might possibly set a bad example to someone else. I thought about that in terms of our current situation, and I think it means that I must respect and submit to the conditions of our current lockdown, whatever I may think of some of them. Some people are buying cigarettes and alcohol on the black market. Many go into public places without wearing a mask. I saw 3 police cars last week, each with 2 or 3 people inside, and they were not wearing masks. Some people are out visiting friends, even having parties. But as a citizen of South Africa, I must obey the laws of this country. But more than that, Jesus teaches us that as his followers, we must set a good example. Christianity and good citizenship go together. That's something to remember if we are tempted to take any advantage during these current restrictions. I hope that we are all doing the right thing, being good examples to others, and staying safe. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, help me never to forget that you are an awesome God. You are due all honor and praise. You are almighty, all-powerful. And that is so good to know as we face such an uncertain future. In this time of the COVID-19 pandemic, with its resulting increase in poverty, along with the corruption and the abuse of women and children, it is so good to know that you are all-powerful and that you love us. Thank you, Lord, for all that you give to us, for all that you mean to us, for all that you do for us. We continue to pray for our leaders, especially our President Cyril Ramaphosa. We pray for wisdom, strength, energy, and integrity. And we pray against any corruption amongst our leaders. And Lord, we pray that we, all of us, may respect them and their decisions and keep to the rules and regulations that they decide upon. We pray for the healing of those who have contracted COVID-19 and for the healing of all those on our pew leaflet. We pray too for all those at the forefront of fighting the pandemic. Father, we are so grateful for all that you have provided for us. We ask that we will have open hands and hearts to provide for those who have less than we do. Thank you, Lord, that in your name we have our help. Amen. Let us pray together the COVID collect. God bless the world. Give it wisdom at this time. Grant us relief and release. Be with those who are ill and bless the carers fighting this pandemic. For Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. Please join me as we pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Shall we pray together the prayer for Africa? God bless Africa, protect our women and children, transform our leaders, heal our communities, restore our dignity, and give us peace. For Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. And let us again share the peace, the grace with one another. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and always. Amen. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
And so, stay safe. Keep within the restrictions. Lots and lots of love.